Hey, this is Papa from StreetFighterTrainingSystem.com. All right, guys. So, we continue our training. So we are at day four. So the lesson of today is basically it's gonna be a lesson that we are going to do quite often. Not the lesson, but the training that we are going to do quite often is like doing push-ups, right? Doing push-ups every day. The idea is just you go on your chart, you count. And then you see what is happening, right? So I'm gonna give the count, then I'm gonna also give you advice for those who are a little bit more advanced to look at what I call market structure, okay? And then I will focus on a few trades to show you like why actually only listening to me, okay, and also looking at statistics is not enough. You need screen time to make your own opinion on trades. And try to find hypotheses on why a trade doesn't work or a trade works, right? It's something that you, even with the dashboard that I propose, right? Even with this, you cannot really see it because it's not possible to cover all the parameters in the world, right? It will give you like guidance on what you should be looking at. So let's say good candlestick, which has a higher probability or early in the party, but it will not give you like all the stuff possible. Okay, so we can add like millions of columns, but it will take time, right? So if you do your own research and if you do the work on your own, then you will have a better chance of succeeding. Okay, so the day of today. So I think I also post on Facebook usually. I try to post on Facebook. So there is also other couple of guys. So Darian, Dean, there's Gabriel also that is contributing on the chat on the Google Sheet. There is a guy named David, which is also kind of super good on his way of telling new stuff, right? So take a look at it. I think it's interesting to understand like the point of view of different traders on what is happening, right? But anyway, so on what I saw is that on the chart number one, if you look at it, I say that there is basically basically 14 failed two-legged pullback, so Shoryu Punish. So normally if you go into your chart, you should find this, and then what I propose to you is to basically go into it and try to find this, and then once you have pointed it all, you try to check my solution and see what it is, right? So usually what I will do is that I will put in like in a rectangle the trades that I take, that I would have taken. Okay, in a round circle is the trade that failed, and then I point with just an arrow those who are the entry bar. Okay, so 14 trades. I think I said that I have like six long with three lost, and seven short with one lost. Okay, so this is what you should see on your chart. So it's one thing to count. But then what I want you to focus on now is to try to draw a market structure. So market structure is simply drawing impulse, drawing retrace, drawing impulse, drawing reload, drawing channels. Okay, so what you do is that you should have one chart which only have the market structure. So what I do is I usually have like something where, so you see, normally every time I will draw, right, my path, so by default, I put the option to draw on all charts, okay? So I will have two type of 2000 tick chart open. Here on the tab, you will see on the down, I will have two tabs, okay, that are duplicate. And then I will have this thing that will apply on all charts, okay? So this, I will have one chart without basically market structure, and I will have one where I will try to draw all the market structure. So let me show you a little bit how I do. Right, so to draw market structure, what I would do is that I would just try to draw the impulse move, right? So I would draw a line, so I have like a shortcut hotkey just to draw like a line, right? So I would just draw this on my impulse. So for example, I have first impulse, so the day starts over here. Yeah, I have one impulse, second impulse, third impulse, okay? Then I have here like a reload pattern, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so the party restarts, okay? Then I have again an impulsive move, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so after the 6, what I will be, so normally after 4, I will be trying to hunt for a failed two-legged pullback, right? So a reversal. So it happens over here after the 6. It's a very good trade over here. Then reload. If it reload, I start again by 1. 1, 2. Okay? So here it's a reload. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then I have a 1, 2, 3. Okay? 4. This could be considered also as a fourth impulse. It's a small one. It could be one, right? So after this one, I will also look for failed two-legged pullback. And another thing, you will see it will come with experience, but I don't know, I haven't checked, but I'm pretty sure that if I look at my stochastic indicator, okay, we will have a divergence over here. So usually when we have like 1, 2, 3, and we have a fourth impulse, which is a divergence, we can look at a failed two-legged pullback, right? So maybe let's pull it, right? So we see 1, 2, 3, 4, and here you see that it's doing a divergence. So a divergence, what does it mean? Is that it's doing a low on the chart. So here it's a lower low, but you see here on my divergence indicator is doing a higher low. Okay. So anyway, as I said, you don't need to have in any case this. Another way to understand that this is a good, right, is as I said, you need to draw your impulse, but another thing that you have to draw, okay, is your market structure. So one thing interesting in this, so I'm gonna crop it and I'm gonna show you why it's interesting. So I repeat, we have a 1 impulse, 2 impulse, 3 impulse, and maybe 4, right? But let's say that you haven't seen the 4. What you should see, okay, is also every time that you have, every time you have channel, so a channel, not the channel where you have to draw the trend, right? This is ridiculous and I think it's not useful. What I mean by channel is the range, okay? So let's say every time that you have 2 bars that are stacked together, so 2 bars or 3 that does a same high, so that close at the same high position, you should draw it. Okay, so here you have 1, 2, 3, you draw your horizontal line. Okay, here you have 1, 2, 3, you draw your horizontal line. You have 1, 2, 3, you draw your horizontal line, okay? So what you would have seen here is that you have something called a failed breakout. So it breaks, it comes back, okay, over here, right? So this is often when it does this, right? It breaks, it fades, but you should be scouting either for higher low, which happens over here. This is a higher low, right? Or for the failed two-legged pullback, which happens over here, right? So this is basically, as I said, situation that you cannot you cannot basically look at only by looking at the dashboard. You need to look at it only if you're able to draw market structure, right? So you had a 1, 2, 3. This is also like a 4, right? Well, normally I will not draw it because it's a small impulse. But what you would have seen also is after the 3, it pushed a little bit lower, right? And then it broke this range and then came back, right? It did a higher low, which is over here. And after the higher low, you had the failed two-legged pullback. And often those trades are quite good, okay? Anyway, so this is one situation. Another type of situation I wanted to talk about. And as I said, here I mark in round, okay, the trade that failed. But you know what, when I was on team, so yesterday, I will still look at the market and I will take them, right? So I will try to take them and try to memorize what works and what doesn't work. It's okay because we are in sim, right? So we're in sim mode, so we're not losing our money. And the solo purpose is for us to learn, okay? So why those trades are failing? Okay, so one common pattern that I'm seeing over now, right, is something that I also commented on the chat, right? So by observing the market, what I'm seeing is that often, right, so first try to see the reload pattern. So as I said, you draw your impulse, you draw your horizontal channels, you try to see if you have reload. So reload is if you have, you can count 5 waves to the downside, right? And that goes below the SMA, but the SMA is still kind of angling up, right? So you had 1 year, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then it angled up, so it restarts. That's why year we had 3, we have a reload, it restarts at 1. Year it we were at 6, we have a reload, it restarts at 1 over here, okay? So the situation that I want to talk about is this, right? So here you see that we had a trade, so one, so failed to legged pullback that failed over here, okay? So I try to understand because it happened multiple times, right? So this one over here, this one over here, and this one over here, right? So I try to find what is common and why does those trades fail, okay? So you can look at the Facebook, or I'm going to repeat what I have done, right? So like that, you can see on the chart by yourself, okay? So the pattern that I saw fail is this one. So it happened like at 9:25 tight time. So what you do is, so I'm going to screenshot this part, right? And what you need to see is to see that you had 3 waves. So you had a 1. So sorry, the color of red is fucked up. So how can I? So I'm going to change the color. I like lime to show my wave, right? So I have a 1 impulse, 2 impulse, and this is the 3rd impulse, okay? And what we see is the structure of failed two-legged pullback. It does a A, B, C, D, so A, okay, B, so let me draw it again. For it to be more clear, I'm going to draw it on the upside, okay? So it does this and then this, okay? So this up. Sorry, I'm having some difficulties today. So A, B, C, D, E. Okay. So what we see is that the C and D, the length of the C and D is higher than AB. Okay. So if CD is higher than AB, okay, and you are on the 3rd impulse, okay, what I'm seeing is that it very often fails, okay? So 3rd impulse, and if the structure of CD, right, so this, right, so this thing is higher than AB, then I see that it often fails, okay? So this is one of it. Right, but and of course, if you have 1, it's not enough to prove anything, right? So next time, I want you to take a look at those structures. When you have 3 impulse and this, check if it fails or not. So this is one example. Second example that happened on that day, exact same thing, but on the short side, okay? So it happened at midnight, right? So again, I'm going to point it out. So what you see here is that you had so you had 1 impulse, 2 impulse, 3 impulse, okay? So this trade over here, it's a failed two-legged pullback, but it failed, right? So it's a show you punish that failed because it didn't did our 1 point scalp and it came back, right? It broke lower and then boom, it went higher, right? So again, we have a 1, 2, 3. And we have here the structure. So this it does like this. So down, up. And we have a structure where basically you have your A, B, so, oh my gosh. So B, C, D, E. Okay, so you can see that the CD is longer than AB, right? So CD longer than AB, okay? And it's the 3rd wave. So often what it does is that it does the fail-to-legged pullback, it fails, and then it retraces a little bit further, and then it goes lower, right? So maybe on those situations, I said, maybe you should not take here this thing, but you should consider and look at a further retrace and then take it, okay? Or not take it at all. So another example to show you that it's maybe not a random move, right? If you go on yesterday, right, you had kind of a similar situation where you had this move. So it was before the market open, right after the market open. So over here, so it was yesterday 8:30 and the same type of trade failed, right? So again, you take your screenshot and screenshot it and also put it on your log file, right? So what I do, I will show you after, is all those situations, I have those on the file. So you have a one impulse, two impulse, three impulse, okay? And then you have your failed to legged pullback that happens here. You would have placed a short over here and then it would have failed, came back and then pushed down, okay? So here again, this is, so you have this thing that does this, okay? So AB, C, D, E, okay? So if you have this, right, so CD greater than AB, right? So I hope you can see it, right? So maybe let me draw it with this color, so in purple. So you have this, up, right? So this is A, this is B, C, D, okay? So here you see that CD, the length, is greater than AB. Right, so on those type of situation, and it's the third wave, okay, so it's the third impulse, right, imp, so 1, 2, 3, you see again, same situation, it failed over here, it retraced, and then boom, it pushed. So as I said, either you should not take them, or you should consider a further retrace and then take it, right? And then it did what we call like a bullish bearish setup, so a booby, right? Setup, right? So again, it's not something that I can define by looking at the Google Sheet with all the examples, right? But it's something that you can definitely work on. So I put it here on Facebook again. So if you don't have it and if you don't crop it on my videos, you can still go on the Facebook to take a look at how I comment this, okay? A last situation that I comment over here is basically on a market situation where I have a reload. Okay, so a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and what I saw on the 1,000 tick on the 2,000 tick chart is often when you get a reload, right? You have a good higher low that is happening just after, right? So if I look at this, so you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, okay, and then you have a higher low over here, right? So this is your higher low. And then you have a fail-to-legged pullback that failed, by the way, just after. So yeah, it ticks higher, right? So this, by the way, it's the outside bar type of fail-to-legged pullback that for the moment we are not really taking care of it. We'll maybe do some other deep dive around the 15 day on those setup. Those, as I say, is the favorite setup of Mr. Papi. Me, I usually don't take them, but I think it's an interesting setup to take a look at to understand on which situation does those setup work, okay? So I wanted to show you also, so as I said, have on top of the log file where you draw all your fail-to-legged pullback, draw something where you put your mistakes. So me, I put them. And I will tell you yesterday, right? One thing is I even took a two-legged pullback. I don't even want. So you see, I put not even sure why I tried a two-legged pullback. So I was trying to convince myself that I could take two-legged pullback. So I had the down, up, down, and I took long over here, and then I lost, of course, because two-legged pullback are fucked up. But yeah, so I'm putting like my mistakes and market situation where I go on sim and I just take them, right? So here is where you see I'm trying to see maybe place an order way higher when the trap happens. We can think of taking a little move when CD greater than AB. Right, so this is how I'm coming up with all what I'm saying to you, right? It's because I'm logging basically some of the market situation, and then I try to see why I'm making mistakes. Okay, so this was Papa from StreetFighterTradingSystem.com. I hope this was useful. I hope that you are training. We still have 26 days left before I show you how you can basically go with real money, but not your real money, with something else. Okay, all right, see you guys.